Hey Falcons, welcome back. Here I am in my kitchen once again. And this time we're gonna play with some jalapenos. From time to time, I have students in class that ask about appetizers and simple party foods. So here we go. I'm sure once this whole quarantine thing is over, you're gonna be gathering up with your friends and hanging out and doing that sort of stuff under a controlled environment. So I got some jalapenos. I got a little bit of cream cheese, some sharp cheddar, Tillamook, a little bit of bacon I cooked ahead of time, pepper, onion powder, and salt. So pretty simple, pretty basic things. So with our jalapenos, the recipe that I have provided you guys tells you just to cut these right in half. So you're gonna do two halves, which is totally fine. I like to just take like a third of the pepper off so I can put a little more stuffing in it and then have a little bit better structure as well. So we'll throw these in our scrap bowl and then we'll get these cleaned up. I'm just using this melon baller. I'm gonna scoop out the ribs and the pith, the white part in there, and the seeds. Get those seeds out as you can. Hey guys, welcome back. Sorry about the technical difficulty there. Our camera, we have one of these tripods that is adjustable or articulating. I'm not sure exactly what, but anyhow, apparently the weight of the camera is just the right weight or the maximum weight for that little tripod, and gravity did its thing. So anyhow, Cameron is holding on to the cord at this point, and we're reset and we're going at it. Round two of easy recipe jalapeno poppers. All right. Excuse me. All right. Take a drink of water. We'll be right back. Guys, welcome back. Third time is a charm. I had a little tickle in my throat, so I had to get a drink of water. All right, we'll make our filling here, and what I got is I cut the recipe in half, so I got a couple strips of bacon, and I cooked mine up ahead of time. Just cut it up, cooked it, and I'm gonna just put it in with my filling. The recipe I'm providing you, it offers you to do it bacon wrapped. I don't like to do bacon wrap because it's just kind of a weird bite. I'd rather just put it all in the filling. So, and what I mean by that is that the bacon, if you're using thick cut bacon, it's not gonna cook all the way, and you're gonna have like, not raw bacon, but you're just gonna have soft bacon. And then when you bite it, the whole strip of bacon comes off. But if you put it into your filling here, you get a nice uniform mixture of it, and you can take these in a couple of bites. Without making a mess or a fool of yourself. So I got my cream cheese. I got my bacon. This is cheddar cheese. This is Tillamook sharp cheddar because they were all out of just a plain old cheddar. When I went to Freddy's. So I got that bit of cheddar. And then I'm gonna do just a little bit of the onion powder. So a little bit of that. A couple cranks of the black pepper here. And then a little bit of salt. Just a little bit. You don't need a ton because the bacon's got salt and cheese has got salt. So just bringing this all to life. So I'm gonna fill these with my mixture and then we'll bake these. And then I've got some fresh chives out in the backyard that are growing that I might use as a little garnish on top. I've seen people take like goldfish crackers or Doritos or chips and crumble those up and put on top. But we're gonna put something fresh on it. Either something fresh or something crispy just to give it a little bit of extra texture. So we got those stuffed there. If you're gonna wrap these in bacon instead of add the bacon to the filling, at this point you would just wrap that bacon around the outside of these. If you have thick cut bacon, again, that time, they may not cook in that amount of time. So what I recommend, put it on a baking sheet like this, the bacon out straight, and cook it for like 5 or 6 minutes, give it a par bake, let it cool, and then wrap these, and then do a second bake with the whole thing. So. We're gonna put these in, let these go, and then I'm gonna find something to put on top of these, some sort of a, I'm thinking crispy, I don't know, we'll see. We'll see what we got, we'll come back. Hey guys, we're back. We have our jalapeno poppers in the oven for about 25 minutes. I turned on the broiler for the last minute just to get a little bit of color on the top. Cameron did get his way, even though he's not eating any of these, and we did put the crumbled goldfish crackers on top. So I took about a half a bag of these goldfish crackers, and I just smashed those up, and then I put just a little bit of olive oil in there, and then spread a little bit right on top. So, let me get these guys out of the oven. Uh-oh, we had a casualty. Looks like one fell over. That's okay. So here are our little poppers. I also got some chives out of the garden and we cut those up real small so we can hit it with just a little sprinkle of those. And I think these are gonna be pretty fantastic. So go on with your own creations. I hope they turn out well. Stay healthy, make good choices. See you guys soon.